Thank you for joining with me. We are in A Course in Miracles. This is the combined volume by the Foundation for Inner Peace. We are picking up our reading in Chapter 30, The New Beginning, Section 4, The Truth Behind Illusions. Let's pause and say a prayer. Dear Father, if left to my own devices, my perception will be skewed. I surrender to you everything that I think and feel. Please take my past, plan my future, send your spirit to redeem my mind that I might be set free. May I be your channel, God, and serve the world. May I become who you would have me be, do what you would have me do, go where you would have me go, and say what you would have me say, and to whom. And so it is. I apologize. I was trying to find this card I want to read with you. I am currently in a Pathways of Light minister program. I am already a Course in Miracles minister through Teachers of God. But I've been participating in the Pathways of Light education. And that should be done actually in April this year. Oh no, not April, June. So I'm very excited about that. Because A Course in Miracles is truly my life in this world. And I'm excited about becoming a minister through Pathways of Light. Love holds no grievances. Today, I will hold no grievances because I am willing to remember that I am love. I live the sacred life as I remember my safety in love instead of defense. All right, let us move into our reading, The Truth Behind Illusions. Appearances deceive because they are appearances and not reality. Dwell not on them in any form. They but obscure reality, and they bring fear because they hide the truth. Do not attack what you have made to let you be deceived, for thus you prove that you have been deceived. Attack has power to make illusions real, yet what it makes is nothing. Who could be made fearful by a power that can have no real effects at all? What could it be but an illusion making things appear like to itself? Look calmly at its toys and understand that they are idols which but dance to vain desires. Give them not your worship, for they are not there. Yet this is equally forgotten in attack. God's son needs no defense against his dreams. His idols do not threaten him at all. His one mistake is that he thinks them real. What can the power of illusions do? Appearances can but deceive the mind that wants to be deceived. And you can make a simple choice that will forever place you far beyond deception. You need not concern yourself with how this will be done, for you cannot understand. But you will understand that mighty changes have been quickly brought about when you decide one very simple thing. You do not want whatever you believe an idol gives. For thus the Son of God declares that he is free of idols, and thus is he free. Salvation is a paradox indeed. What could it be except a happy dream? It asks you but that you forgive all things that no one ever did, to overlook what is not there and not to look upon the unreal as reality. You are but asked to let your will be done and seek no longer for the things you do not want. And you are asked to let yourself be free of all the dreams of what you never were, and seek no more to substitute the strength of idle wishes for the will of God. Here does the dream of separation start to fade and disappear. For here the gap that is not there begins to be perceived without the toys of terror that you made. No more than this is asked. Be glad indeed. Salvation asks so little, not so much. It asks for nothing in reality, and even in illusions it but asks forgiveness, be the substitute for fear. Such is the only rule for happy dreams. The gap is emptied of the toys of fear, and then its unreality is plain. Dreams are for nothing, and the Son of God can have no need of them. They offer him no single thing that he could ever want. He is delivered from illusions by his will, but restored to what he is. What could God's plan for his salvation be, except a means to give him to himself? And that is the conclusion of section 4 in chapter 30. I thank you so much for joining with me. I love you. I hope you have a lovely day, and I will see you tomorrow. We will pick up on section 5 of chapter 30, The Only Purpose. I love you. See you then.